द नेक्स्ट वीडियो डील्स विद द प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट टेंस. द प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट टेंस विच इज द थर्ड सबडिविजन ऑफ प्रेजेंट टेंस. ओके, नाउ प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट टेंस is used to indicate that an action has been completed just now or a little time back. Now let's take the example. For example, I have finished the painting just now. I have finished the painting just now. Now when you take this into consideration, what do you find here? Have finished is indicating the present perfect tense in the sentence. But what is to be taken note of is the time. Take a note of the time. For example, now when you are action of painting, this has finished a little time back. So past time, there is a diagram which I have with the help of the diagram, I have tried to indicate about the action of painting which has finished a little time back. So have finished, this is indicating the past time, and this particular sentence, painting just now, is in the present time. So this is the time. The time is the past time. The action of painting has finished a little time back. Second is to indicate the action that has taken place in the past, but the action so completed has its effect in the present. Now let's take the example. Say, I have completed my painting, so I am free now. Is that clear? Now, in this sentence, you will find I have completed my painting indicating the past time, and I am free now is indicating the present time. So, action has been finished. Action has been finished in the past time, and in the present, it has the effect. So, a finished action has its effect in the present time. So in that case, you are using the present perfect tense. Then the third, to indicate that the action began at some time in the past but is continuing up to the present time of speaking. Let's take the example. What is being told here? My friend has been ill since yesterday. He is still well. So, now this same sentence can be taken in the past time as well as in the present. So, action began in the past. My friend has been ill since yesterday. So, this is indicating the past. Since yesterday, the friend has been ill. And still continuing to be ill. He is still ill is in the present. So still continuing in the present. So in such case, you are using present perfect tense. Has been ill. Okay. And an important note that has to be kept in mind. Since is used in the present perfect shows that the verb takes effect from a specific event or point of time in the past until now. For example, I have known him since 2015. Okay, I have known him since 2015. And you can use for. It's used to refer to a period of time. It is used here to refer to a period of time. For example, I have known him for 5 years. Okay, so this is the difference in the use of since and for. Since you can use in the present perfect form to show that the verb takes effect from a specific time, specific point of time or the specific event. Here since 2015 is the specific point of time. And in the second example where you have to use for is, it refers to a period of time. So period of 5 years has been taken into consideration. The next rule to use present perfect tense, that is to describe a past action, the time of which is neither definite nor indicated. So time is neither definite nor indicated. For example, he has gone to Delhi. So in this, what is being referred here? The present perfect tense is never used with adverbs, adverb phrase. So this is the note that you have to keep in mind. Yesterday, last year, on March 2020, you are not using present perfect tense. Hence he has gone to Delhi. Yesterday is incorrect. Okay, so this is what you have to keep in mind. So to describe a past action, the time of which is neither definite nor indicated, you will use present perfect form. But also keep in mind that you cannot use adverb or adverb phrases like yesterday, last year. Therefore, if you are framing a sentence, you can frame it in this way. He has gone to Delhi. But you cannot, if you write yesterday, then it becomes an incorrect sentence. Now, the last one, the fourth subdivision, which is the present perfect continuous tense. Now, this present perfect continuous tense can be used in these ways: for action in progress throughout a period. When an action is in progress throughout a period, you can use the present perfect continuous tense. You can use it with verbs suggesting continuity. Okay? For repeated actions and for drawing conclusions. These are the rules that you have to keep in mind when you are framing present perfect continuous tense. Okay, so for example, for action in progress throughout a period, for example, she has been dancing here since morning. It means what? The meaning of the sentence is what? She is still dancing or has just finished dancing. It means that. When the verb is suggesting continuity, in that case you can use present perfect tense. For example, I have been working for 10 years. So it is showing the continuity here. Repeated actions. I have been knocking at the door. Knocking at the door is the continuous action. Okay. For drawing conclusions. The room stinks. Someone has been frying fish here. So conclusion. Stinking of the room is related to what? Frying of the fish. So this is the conclusion that you have drawn on for why the room is stinking. Okay, so these are the rules that you have to keep in mind when you are framing a present perfect continuous tense sentence. Okay, so today we have discussed the four subdivisions of present tense. And in the next video, we'll be discussing the four subdivisions of the past tense forms. Thank you.